What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to our College Football Revamped Triple Option Coaching Carousel. It has been a minute since I have done one of these, but we are back, and also, if this video comes out before then, our Northwestern Death Penalty Dynasty is also coming back. Episodes on that have already been scheduled, so make sure to look out for that. But today, we're coming back to the triple option only coaching carousel. We are still at Akron. We are currently 1-4. We've only played two games. We played the first two against UCF and FCS. Today we're going to be playing Ohio and also another game. I'm not sure which one yet, but I'll figure that out after we beat Ohio. Once again, this is only a coaching carousel, so I'm not the head coach. I'm only the OC. I will not be doing any recruiting. And after this year, we are most likely going to a different school, hopefully a 2-star, because we are currently at a 1-star. And of course, we're only allowed to use the option playbook, which has like flexbone, wishbone, stuff like that. The name of the series is a little misleading. I'm not just running triple option plays. I'm running a triple option offense, kind of like Georgia Tech used to run or Army runs right now. I'm actually using the Army playbook. But yeah, pretty much just flexbone and wishbone. That's all I'm going to be running as formations go. Last time I did this, Akron did not have their new uniforms in this game. So we're playing with these brand new uniforms that Akron has. They're pretty nice. I like the helmets. Not a lot of combinations, but these are definitely better than the old ones. Also, I got the new update, which has this nice ESPN scoreboard, so it might be a little bit laggy. So if it is, then that's because of the scoreboard, so I apologize. Well, I just found out that Cato Nelson is injured, so that's great, even though I literally practiced with him. Whatever. We will win without him. Okay, let's go hand up the middle, and there goes Childs for a first down. Good run. They stopped us on 3rd and 1. All right, defense got to stop. Good stuff. We need to get some offense going. Let's try this sweep to Dollard, and the edge is not sealed. Circle is open. Oh, come on to Shields. What was that? Go Knight. Get the first down. Run him over. Oh, look at the effort by Jeremiah Knight. Let's go. There we go. First down by DeShields. Good run. Oh, good blocking up the middle. Childs for 8. We're going to try a 48-yard field goal. Let's see if we can get it. It is going to be short. Yeah, our kicker does not have enough power for that. We're down 7. There is 1:24 left in the half. Let's see if we can maybe score. Nobody's really open. Let's just try to get it to circle. That didn't work. Okay, second half. We're still down 7. We're on like our own 2-yard line as well. So that's not ideal. Come on, get it, Dollard. Get it, Dollard. Oh, my goodness, he ran over, man. And the step back by Dollard. What a move. This man is insane. There we go. Good move by Knight up the sideline. He's got the first down a whole lot more. That's 19 yards for Knight. Get it. There we go. First down. First and goal for the Zips. Third and goal from the 2. We need to go to a pass. They are stacking it real good. Triangle's open. That's Knight, and that's a touchdown for Akron. It is a 1-score game with 2 minutes left. Hopefully the defense can get a stop. And the defense does get a stop with 1:08 to go. We are down 1 score. We have no timeouts, though. And we're also running the flex bone, so not ideal. But X is kind of open. And almost picked off. He's out of bounds. Oh, there we go. First down to Stewart. Oh, that's picked off. Not a great throw. Not a whole lot we can do there with this offense. It's just not built for these situations. Not a great way to start the episode. We lost 14-7 to Ohio. I mean, we're a pretty bad team. We're like one of the worst teams in the country. So it's not a terrible loss, but not a great way to start things today. Quickly going over these game stats before we get into the next one. DeShields was 3 of 11 for 21 yards, a touchdown, and an interception. Of course, he is the backup, so I didn't expect a whole lot from him. Childs had 11 for 42. Dollard had 8 for 38 with a long of 25, a great run by him. DeShields had 6 for 17. And Jeremiah Knight had 2 for 31. And Jeremiah Knight also had a touchdown catch, and Stewart had the only other catches with 19 yards. Our next game for today will be against Georgia Southern. They are 5-2, we are 2-7. They are still better than us, but not by a whole lot, so this is a very winnable game. And Cato Nelson is back in the lineup, so that is very good news. Good to have him back. He is a very good quarterback, and as you can see, he's much faster than DeShields, and he's got 8 yards on the first play. There he goes again. Let's go. He's off to the races. He is down the sideline for 26 more yards. Great start. Don't pick that off. Dang it. We had the setup play, too. Just a bad throw. Here we go, Knight. Down the sideline, he's got the edge, and he's got another 21 yards for the offense. There we go. Nelson's got the first down and more. He's out of bounds. Square is open. There we go, Stewart with the catch. Third and four from about the 5-yard line. We can get a first down at the 1, but I am going for this touchdown. Up the middle, that's Nelson with the touchdown for Akron, first of the day, with about 3 minutes to go in the half. X is open, make the throw. Oh my gosh, Gato, what are you doing?
It's an easy
throw. Oh my gosh, I got hit. Just don't let him return it back. That's going to be the end of the half, and we are tied at 7. Okay, head coach is letting us go for it. So let's make the most of this opportunity. There we go. Good pitch to Dollar. That's a first down. 3rd and 6. Let's pick this up, please. X is open. Good throw to Dollar. And he fumbled. What the heck are you doing? He fumbled it. What in the world? That's 4 turnovers today. Alright, so the defense got a pick 6 apparently and got the ball back, so good job by them. There we go, touchdown. Cato Nelson to Nate Stewart. We're going to be up by 2 scores. Great throw. Okay, I guess the defense scored again and they led a touchdown, so we're up by 15 with about 4 minutes to go. Perfect time to run some clock. Or fumble it. That's fine too. There we go. Go Nelson. Go Nelson. Outrun him. He breaks the tackle. Let's go. To the 40-yard line. 29 yards for Cato Nelson.
What?
Oh my gosh. What was that pitch? What in the world? Okay. Thankfully, the defense did not give up the 2-point conversion, so we're still up by 2 scores. So we should just be able to run the clock out pretty much. They do have 3 timeouts, so basically we're just going to run 3 plays, and if we don't get the first down, then it's fine. Because it's still a 2-score game with just a minute to go. And the defense gets the ball back, so we got the game in the bag. Well, thankfully, we are going to win at least one game today. We beat Georgia Southern 28-19 after the defense really stepped up in the second half. Cato Nelson in his first game back was 4 of 9 for 74 yards, a touchdown, and 2 picks. He really wasn't very good in the air today, but in this offense, I really don't need him to be. He was by far the leading rusher today with 18 carries for 106 yards and a touchdown. Childs had 7 for 7. Dollard had a down day, 6 attempts for just 13 yards. Knight had 3 for 23. And for some reason, our punter had 1 for 5. I'm not sure how that happened. Nate Stewart, 2 for 34 and a touchdown. Jeremiah Knight also had a catch for 23 yards. And Dollar had a catch for 17 yards. That's going to do it for today's episode. Hope you all enjoyed. In the next episode, we will be playing our last game of the season against Western Michigan. There will not be a bowl game because we're not making a bowl game. We've already lost 7 games this year. But after the Western Michigan game, we will be doing the coaching carousel and picking our new school. So if you have any lower tier schools that you'd like to see me go to, let me know in the comments. And if I get an offer from them, then I will definitely consider it. If you made this far in the video, make sure to give it a like and a sub to the channel to make sure you don't miss any more of these episodes. Also, make sure to sub to my second channel. Link to that is in the description. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.